Contestant number three. Satyamurthy, Ramanujam, Satyamurthy, Ramanujam, contestant number three.
Good morning, my invisible audience, judges, all the other Toastmasters, and a very good morning to Toastmaster Anand Pillai. I will start the evaluation with the title of your speech. Here is a well, don't fall into it. What an intriguing title. It invites the attention of the audience immediately. You had three stories in your speech. Each story was very interesting. And you created great imagery about the hotel, the cleaning staff, what she is doing, the hidden cameras that were fit in. And all these stories made a great impact into our minds on what you are going to tell us, what message you are leading us to. And there was relevance of these stories to your main message. And I like some of the phrases that were used about people. Though there was the cleaning woman did a wrong thing, not wearing the same gloves, not changing it after cleaning the toilet, she went and cleaned the drinking glasses and placed them, and how it created a great reputation loss for that hotel chain. And you gave great statistics also about the coffee shop and people losing jobs because of stealing money from the chain. Then you quoted a research report. And finally, you told us that every person is born good, but it is because of the ignorance they commit mistakes or wrong things. And you said also a solution that training is very important for people to not commit mistakes because they are intentionally not doing those mistakes, causing great reputation losses to great organizations. Now I will go to certain points which I thought lacked in your speech. One, this is an online meeting. Yes, our home is our stage, but we are talking to a wider range of people. All of your speech, which needed a lot of body language, actually was delivered from a sitting position in your chair near your computer. If you had stood up, you could have freed yourself and used your hands and your face, little gestures you could have added to your speech. I felt your dress. It's an online contest. We are at home, but we should not come in pajama and t-shirts. You know, see me, I am wearing a tie and I am formally dressed because it's a Toastmaster contest. Your attire could have been stronger because you are giving an important message to people. Then you quoted a research, but did not quote what is the source of that research. The source of the research would have added value. And then you brought in the COVID story. The COVID story could have been not that important. Considering all this, I feel if you add your body language to your story and stood up and delivered and better attired, you would have done a great job. Thank you very much. Over to the contest master.